Hey Co-Eirider, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is your Emobility Guru, Mr. Boo. So, today's video, we're going to start already our DIY electric scooter retro style. Okay? So, we're gonna start first with our electric motors. We're gonna put already these tires on this one. We're gonna fit in. And then, later on, we're gonna try to fit already the 010X plate on the Ninebot Max. So we're gonna do some cuttings and measurements. So we're gonna fit in the rear 10X plate to the Ninebot Max chassis. Okay, so as for today, we're gonna do some things on the retro electric scooter. Let's see whatever we can do as for today, and then on our next video, day by day, we're gonna do some videos. Each and every part we're gonna fix on our DIY electric scooter retro style. Okay, so let's start, Co-Eirider. Join me. Okay, so let's start with removing this brake disc. Okay, so we're gonna change this one as well, make it look better. So the motor that we're gonna use for our retro electric scooter will be 3000 watts. So you can see here, so we're gonna use the 50 volts 3000 watts electric motor. Since this one is 52, but we can use as well the 48 volts controller for this one. Okay, let's go to the next one. Okay, so we removed already this two disc brakes. So let's separate these screws. We're gonna need them later. Now we're gonna fit in our new tires. Okay, so the same method what we're gonna use. Okay, this size, for this size, this one is tubeless, so we're gonna do the same process. So we're gonna use this cable ties for us to easily insert these tires on the hub motor or fit in. Okay, doing this one for you, for the for someone out there who's new to my channel. So this cable tie is used if you don't want to get, do some scratches on your hub motors. This will be easily fit in on the hub motors when you use this cable ties. Okay, so as you can see the gap, it should be like this one, because this one will be fitting in between this thing. Okay, so once we're done like this one, so we're gonna need to make them close as much as possible. There you go. Okay, so once you check already the orientation, so this one will turn like this, so you need to position it like this, and then before you insert, you'll need some WD-40, see? Okay, for lubrication. Now you can spray it on the sides for you to easily insert this thing without a hassle. Okay, now we're gonna insert it, push it, there you go, as easy as that. So you don't need to scratch all the sides, use some any tools for you just to insert these tires. Okay, next thing to do is get a cutting plier and cut this cable ties for the tires already to stay and fit in. So it won't actually fit directly on this one. You need to put some air on this one, and that air will push us this one up outside, so it will fit on these grooves on the side of the hub motors. Okay, so as you can see, it's already fitting, but we need to put some air later on, so it will push us this thing outside. So now we're done with fitting the tires. There you go. So we'll just add up later on the air, So let's check and get the compressor first. Okay, so we have already the compressor. Now it's time to put some air. So as you can see here, it was stated only for maximum of 50 psi. It's only on 50. Okay, so this one is good. There you go. Strong enough. Okay, now let's go to the second one. Okay, now 50 psi. There you go. Okay, that's it. So there you have it, our two motors, dual motors with the new tires fitted. Okay, so we'll set this one aside for a while and we're gonna work out on our frame. So we're gonna fit the rear plate of the 10X, as I told you earlier, into the Ninebot chassis. Okay, let's go and take it. Okay guys, so here we have our 10X rear plate. There you go. And we're gonna fit in the same as what we've done on our previous project. Now we're gonna need this one for us to measure the space on this thing. Okay, so as you can see, it can be fitted, but the thing is, so there's a small, this one is a bit wider, so we're gonna have to cut it in, cut this thing here and fit it in on inside. Okay, so to be able to do that, we're gonna use this vernier caliper, the digital one. Okay, I use this one, it's easy and very helpful. So let's measure the inside. The size is 127. We're gonna set it to 127. There you go. Now we're gonna lock this thing up. So that's 127. Now what we have to do is to make sure that on both sides, we're gonna remove on both sides equally to make only left is 127.02. to be able to do that, we're gonna have also to measure the width of this one, then we're gonna deduct it from 127. Okay, so this one is 134. Okay, so as you can see here, we've computed already, so the width of the plate is 134.25 less the space for the Ninebot chassis is 127.04, which gives us 7.21. Then we're gonna divide that one into two equal sides to make it 3.6. So I think 605, just round off to 3.6. Okay, so we need to get the caliper and then make it zero, and then we're gonna do the calibration to 3.6. There you go. So 3.6. So what we have to do is use that one. There we go. Okay. On the other side as well. So this will be our basis later on. Where should we cut, how thick it is. So as you can see here, this one is now on, say, 127. Okay, so we're gonna remove this excess for us to fit in. Okay, let's start. Okay, so guys, we're almost done. As you can see, we've removed already the size to make it the usual size to be able to fit on the Ninebot Max. So let's try to fit it. Oh, that's it. See? So that's it. Okay, so as you can see, it's already fit. This is from 10X and this is the Ninebot chassis. So what we're gonna do is try to find the holes from this one. Okay, to be able to do that, we're gonna use a caliper. This is 60.19. So it's just the same. So now what we have to do is to mark this thing so that when we put it back, we'll know where exactly it will align. And also, since we're gonna put this one, the shaft for the swing arm, we'll have to cut all the way from here to this part. So we'll have the space here open for our shaft and the swing arm later on for that 010X. Okay. Now, mark this thing. So we're gonna cut all the way from here. This part. Same is true with the other side. So we're gonna cut this one and later on let's fit again. Okay, so we've done cutting it, so this is not the final one. Later on we're gonna trim this one.
I have to measure the center, so we'll see later on where we're going to put the holes.
Okay, there you go. Same is true with the other side. So see, this is where we're going to put the holes.
Line it on this line here. I don't know if you could see it. Yeah, here. Make the length. These are the holes that we're gonna build.
Okay, so we're gonna make this one as well.
Okay,
I'm gonna bore a hole on this mark. So there you have it, guys. See, the holes is already aligned. So see, holes are aligned as well as here. Holes are aligned. Okay. Okay. There you have it. So now. The last thing we need to do is to double check the space. This one. Yep. Okay. Yep. Same. So that means this one is aligned with this part, so it is straight now. So there you have it. Oh. Okay, so we're just gonna trim this one. Mark this thing and trim it to make it just almost the same as this part, make it look good. Okay, that's it. Okay guys, so you have, there you have it. So we have already our combination of Ninebot Max chassis and the rib plate for the 010X. So that's it for today. So just a summary, so what we've done as for today, we have fitted the dual motors with the new tires and as well as the chassis. So this will be our frame for our retro electric scooter, okay? That's it, guys. So if you're new to my channel, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Hit the bell button below so you'll always be updated on our next video. Don't forget, let's create, ride, and enjoy. See you, Co-Eriders!